My name is Rhapsody, and welcome back to the Binding of Isaac Rebirth. Last time... What the fuck did we do last time? Alright, we played Azazel, and we used Azazel and the Ankh in order to allow ourselves to get a kill on Mom's heart. With the blue baby. Ultimately, our goal was to go to the cathedral and kill Isaac with the blue baby, but, such things did not pan out. Who do I want to play this time? You know what? It's been a while. Let's play Eden. We've got 6 Eden tokens. Eden starts with random stats and random items. I can tell just by looking at Eden's face right now that he has Proptosis, which is mega tears, but they have a very short range. Look at that. So they're clearly doing less damage as they continue onwards. That was Book of Anarchy. Anarchist Cookbook. There we go. That's what that item was. We started with the spacebar item, the Dead Sea Scrolls, which means things, I think. Yes, we started with the item, the Dead Sea Scrolls, but we've immediately replaced it. I just will tell you, for the record, what the Dead Sea Scrolls does. It emulates a random spacebar item, but the problem with that is it's a random spacebar item, so I can't tell you if it's going to be good or not. Which means you don't know when you should use it. Maybe it's really good to use in a room with a lot of rocks. Maybe it's this notched axe. Or maybe it isn't the notched axe, and it's... If you use it in a room alone, you're going to take a lot of damage because it's Monstro's Tooth or something like that. You don't know. So I switched it out for Guppy's Paw, which was available in said... In that curse room. Basically, Guppy's Paw is just trade away a red heart container for 3 temporary soul hearts. But it also gets us 1/3 of the way to being Guppy, and that's more my jam, what I'm interested in, actually. Because being Guppy is one of the few ways you can basically guarantee a win. I say basically, if you have really low... if you have really low damage, he says as he picks a damage up. If you have really low damage... Yeah, bad. Well, not... becoming Guppy is never bad. It gives you flight. It gives you basically the mulligan effect. So you generate flies whenever you hit something. That's real cool. That's... Oh, that's Speedball. Fuck. I thought it was Synth Oil for a second, which is a damage plus range up, which would... Well, let's face it. Our damage is off the fucking hook right now. And it would make it more so off the hook. It would increase the distance between our damage and the general vicinity of the hook. What I'm saying is it'd be good. If I was any smarter, I would have knocked that shit down so that it could I'm gonna go to the shop. I would have knocked the bomb downwards so that I could test the secret room location. Compass is real good. It just shows you the direction of all of the special rooms. Okay. I should be able to get through this fight without taking any damage. At least I don't want to take red heart damage. Fuck. Okay. I didn't take red heart damage. It's fine. We're all good in this hood. That's Guppy's collar. That is a second item towards becoming Guppy. That is a goat's head. That guarantees that I will get a devil or a deal with the angel room every single floor. But I will tell you at this point, spoiler fucking alert, I'm not going to get deals with the angel or deals with God or whatever you want to call them. Because I've already taken a deal with the devil. I spent a heart on a deal with the devil, and that's the important thing. If you actually spend HP in a deal with the devil, then you're basically guaranteed to only get deals with the devil from then on. I believe that's how that mechanic works. Well, I'm certain that's how the mechanic worked in the first game. If you fight Krampus in a deal with the devil room, Or if you say, I don't know, random example out of the blue. If you have three red chests in there, it doesn't count. It doesn't count as taking a deal with the devil, so it's fine. You can pick it up, and then you can have the angels await galore, if you'd like. Okay, I just had to remember very quickly, on my toes, that these guys blow up. When you... you fucker. I want keys, son. Give us keys. I want tinted rocks as well. Okay, thank you. Okay, it's puberty, but that's fine. Puberty actually does nothing, and it tells me that that's not a pill that I want, right? So it's knowledge. And knowing is half the battle. G.I. Joe. I've never watched G.I. Joe. I am an Australian. I've never... The closest I got to watching G.I. Joe is that episode of Community where they spoofed G.I. Joe. I am so sorry to break the news to you. And boom goes the dynamite. Guppy, guppy, guppy. None of them are guppy. I'm noticing a distinct lack of any of these items being guppy items. That's a health down. That's a tears down. What the fuck? Come on, man. I mean, I guess we started with some really good RNG, so we can't exactly be complaining about it, but still, at the same time, fuck, man. Come on. How dare you pull this shit on me? Oh, perfect. That's the key that we're going to be using for our item room. Of course, now that I get salty about it, we're going to go into the item room, and it's going to have stigmata, which is damage plus HP up. I believe, don't fucking quote me on this, but I believe that stigmata, regardless of the amount of damage that you're actually doing, makes your tears red. Alternatively, we now do enough damage that our tears have become red. It might be Blood of the Martyr that I'm thinking of that's doing the, you know, making your tears red, even if you don't have red damage. I know the Toothpicks does the same thing as well, and I know Blood Clot does it to half of your shots. But they're not the actual red. This is the actual red. It actually may well be... Oh, actually, that's where the secret room is. How did you know, Ryan? How did you know? Well, interesting thing. Secret rooms, usually guarded by a lot of rooms, right? So it could be the one above us, because it's got three directly adjacent rooms. Or it could be the one below us, because it's got, well, four directly adjacent rooms. Three is enough, it's fine. But the one above us cannot be accessed from this room unless I had a ladder or flight. So I know, therefore, that this is not one of them. Not a secret room above me. Because I can't get to it from this room. That's something you always want to keep in mind, because if you can't access it from somewhere, that means it's not a secret room. I could bomb my way into the item shop, but I don't I'ma feel bad about this very soon if, there's not theirs options in there. Bomb my way into the item shop. That's a ladder. I don't want a ladder. I don't want a ladder, and I don't want to donate money. I'm not a charitable man. Do that. Tears down. Oh, thank you. Puberty. Excellent. I'll just go fuck myself, shall I? Jesus, game! Lighten up, buddy! Okay. Two across? This is really easy for our opening item room. Always really happy to visit the item room ASAP. Which is, of course, as fast as possible. Now, that's a tinted rock, right there. So, I'm gonna blow that up. And... no. Spider baby? Spider baby. Oh! Oh, it's spider baby! Okay. I'm gonna... So Spider Baby, whenever I take damage, I'm putting out spiders, right? So it's kind of like Infestation, but for spiders. I think I might also spawn spiders when I attack enemies. Or deal damage to enemies? Is it? I always take damage on that room. I can't stop it. I'm sorry. It can't be done. Okay, chest inside a chest. Excellent. Now, this is a key for a key, but... Exactly! That's the fucking point I was about to make. Thank you, game, for proving you right. When you open key locks, sometimes it contains something in it. So I traded for a key for a key, and I got a cent out of it. So, ultimately worthwhile. Of course, not actually incredibly useful, but ultimately worthwhile. Also, important to note, is that, those TNT barrels, always shoot them, even if they don't blow up anything, because they can drop the trinket matchstick, which just happened. What are we on? Catacombs 2? Oh man, we're not even 10 minutes in. We are making decent time right now. Unfortunately, it does look like I'm gonna have to fight a double boss. Oh well. I do want to do it as soon as possible so that I can get the guppy item that's in the devil room. I mean, there is a guppy item in the devil room. I'm telling you that right now. I'm telling the game so that it knows to prepare that guppy item for me. Okay, so there's a torn photo, tears plus shot speed up. This is Krampus. This is very few times out of 10 a guppy item. Lump of coal. So now at range, our tears do more damage. But the problem is we have proptosis. So not only do we first off have shitty range, but secondly, our tears do less damage at range. So it's kind of evening them out a little bit, I guess. By the way, the item there that I haven't taken is Bob's Rotten Brain, Bob's Explosive Brain Thoughts, Bob's Rotten Thoughts of an Explosive Brain. Basically, it's a familiar, and anytime I fire in a certain direction, it'll fire out and then explode, and the explosion can do damage to me. Now, why am I being such a huge pussy and not picking it up? I have short range. If I take something that will damage me when I attack at short range, I'll take damage. It's simple mathematics. Bob's brain plus me equals less life. Oh, he done a poop. Peep? No, it's Megamore. Oh, fuck this guy. Oh, man, I can't believe I managed to dodge that second one there. Okay. I would like to donate as much of the money that I am currently holding as possible. But I will continue to explore the floor just in case of something like a judgment that I want to give my money to first before donation. Because obviously, you know, if I can donate and at the same time get benefits, I'm gonna do that. Guppy, guppy. Okay, that's puberty. Range up actually is surprisingly good for us right now. Very surprisingly incredibly good for us right now. I will probably pop another... Well, first off, I'm going to blow these up. That's not what I expected to do. Okay. I will probably pop another charge of the... Fucking hell. Oh my god, I hate that so much. You know what? I'm going to do this. Huh? Yeah? Game, you want to fuck with me? Let's tango, motherfucker. First off, that goes up. Damn it, of course I take damage, fine. Let's tango. Come on, give me all of your money. I am mugging the game right now. And now I'm gonna play this for a bunch of spirit hearts. Thank you. Thank you. It's being very kind in terms of them. Very generous. Trust good people. Thanks, man. I always do. Two of spades. That should be bombs. That's just a total of 4 bombs right now. Princess is in another castle. Laying it wrong, give me the controller. I think that's actually my favorite one that it says. I will blow this up. Yeah. I figured I might as well do that. Oh, whoa! Two of spades is keys. Man, I screwed up. It's another spirit heart. Magician. Hell yeah. Alright, that was very, very much worthwhile. Even if I took damage there again. I will take Guppy's paw with me because I think it's actually gonna kind of be my safety. Oh, right. Greed was in here, so I can't donate. I still do have one more floor to donate, though. Oh, boy. I'll take the damage to go in here because it could have been Guppy items, but it wasn't Guppy items, so... I need tinted rocks. Oh, fuck me. I would really like a way that doesn't require me taking damage to get some soul hearts. I'm gonna blow up all of these. Okay. Magician. Chariot. Okay. Chariot's pretty good. There's got to be a tinted rock in here somewhere. There has to be. I'm just going to analyze the area. Oh, are you shitting me? First off, are you shitting me because I don't actually have any bombs left because I used them all because I'm an idiot? Ding dong. Oh, man, that shot curved into me like that fucking famous movie. Curve into me. Where the bullets curve into people. We'll take that. Okay, so this is the Dinglemeister. Don't really need to worry about him. Broken magnet, kind of useless. It attracts coins and coins only. Okay, so there's some bombs. Cool. Cool, cool. I'm feeling better, especially now that I've seen that tinted rock. Boom goes the tinted rock. Oh, there's got to be a tinted rock in this room as well. There's so many rocks in this room. I'm just on... I'm not even fucking looking at the enemies. I'm actually autopiloting my combat right now. I am looking at all of the rocks in the room. Like, I wish there was some sort of a ability for me to show you exactly how little fucking attention I was paying to that room while I was doing it. Opting instead entirely to focus for tinted rocks. Which, of course, is dumb, because I could have taken damage while trying to do that, which would have nullified the purpose of picking up a tinted rock. Alright. Starter deck, extra card room. Okay, so I can hold two cards at the same time. I'm gonna donate all of the rest of my money. So, starter deck, I believe, works in the same way as Pillbaggy, which we were using last episode, where you can hold two of a certain item, so in this case, cards, in last case, Pillbaggy, obviously, pills. But I believe it works in the same manner in that if anything is going to spawn a pill, instead of spawning a pill, it now spawns a card. The thing is, cards, always good? Well, they're always okay, at least. They're always not bad, right? Pills, however, can let you down. Oh, look at those hearts. Man, our rate of fire is actually off of this fucking world. Grand. Acropolis 1. Okay. I'm not feeling too great about the amount of time we're taking on these levels now. So I'd really like to hurry it up if I could. Oh, God. There we go. He's done. He's dead. I did take damage on the way, but he's dead. Please be Guppy. Oh, my God. That's good enough that I don't mind. Dark Bum, he wants to take your life. He wants to bum you. Every 1.5 red hearts that Dark Bum picks up, he will drop, or poop out, basically, a a soul heart. So basically, at this point, I can't die, right? Unless I take a bunch of damage in one room. I should not be actually able to die. Because the amount of red hearts that drop in this game is, well, let's face it, absurd. I'm not even going to visit that reroll room because my run is actually really good right now. Rerolling my run could do nothing good for me. So he just picked up half a heart, so next time he picks up a full heart or two more halves of a heart, Dark Bum will poop out a spirit heart for us. Which is excellent because especially when I'm trying to become Guppy, you know, if I become Guppy by taking, say, 9 lives, then I want something that's going to constantly replenish my spirit hearts, because that's the only way I'm going to have health at that point. Really, really good. I am going to... Oh, fuck yes. I was going to go to the arcade only to lose enough HP. Oh my god, I should be playing all of these. I was going to go to the arcade only to lose enough HP that I could activate Horror of Babylon if I picked it up in the item room. But now I actually want to full have the chariot. Oh, I have the chariot. I could have been playing the deal with the devil there. The devil beggar. Oh, man, I'm not going to make it to the boss rush in time. All right, I might as well just capitalize on all of the things here. Yeah, with another judgment card, not only can't I make it to the boss rush, I shouldn't. Actually, probably way more worth my while to just stay here. Fucking hell, you blew up my demon judgment, you prick. All right, so I'm going to go in here and then use the stars card to teleport out. That saves me a key from having to actually access this, the item room. There we go. I got the words out eventually. But also it saves me a half a heart of damage from leaving the curse room. Which is really optimal. Yeah, 20 minutes. I cannot actually access the boss rush mode right now. Even if I were to instantly have killed Mum right now, I wouldn't have enough time. So, now that I've cleared the rest of the level, I will blow that up. A bomb for a bomb? I blew up 2 rocks at the same time, and that's the important thing. Because some of those rocks can contain, you know, secret passageways to the black market. Some of them can contain a bunch of other really cool shit as well. I should have placed the bomb on the other side as well when I was doing the first one. The devil, excellent. That's a lot of damage for one room. Magician, okay. I'll keep the magician, I'll drop the fool. Judgment. You know what? Yes? Oh my god, it's demon judgment. Are you kidding me? Oh, Gimpy. Yes. Oh my god. All right, we're getting really powerful now. Check out the rest of the floor. Yeah, we'll check out the boss trap room. I mean, while we're here, when in Rome, do as the Romans do. Which actually has no relevance to this situation whatsoever. I just wanted to say those words. Boom. Easy. Easy life. I will go down here. Just in case it has some hearts in there that I can use. 5 does not reroll your run. 5 rerolls the floor. And we basically taken all of the benefits from that area that we possibly could have, so might as well reroll the floor. I don't think I took damage there while I was standing inside of the boss. Which is grand, because, you know, he spawned on top of me. It's his fault. Okay, So now I just need to keep in mind that five re- Oh my god, Dark Bomb, I've been stealing all of your hearts. I feel so bad. Oh, no, no, no. Don't take me out of the room. Oh, it took me out of the room. Now I have to fight the whole room again. Man, that's gonna be such a chore. Okay, done. No, not done. There we go. Whew. Almost. Almost faked me out, video game. Dark Bomb got that one. Let's see if he gives me a... Yeah, there we go. Spirit Heart from the Dark Bomb. Thank you, sir. Prayer Card. It's useful. Don't want to use it yet. See, if I go to the arcade, if I have used the Prayer Card, I'm going to lose the Eternal Heart in the arcade when I play the Blood Bank. But the thing is, I definitely want to play Blood Banks and Demon Judgment. Because I have Gimpy, so when I take damage, I have a chance to just drop a Spirit Heart. Oh, it didn't work out any of those times, but it's fine. We've got enough money to gamble on these guys for a while. I think our luck is actually pretty low, so we shouldn't win on any of these. I might just blow them off if we don't win. Seriously, nothing from any... Oh, thank you, at least. Your death will be quick and painless. Relatively. Two more cents. Are you kidding me? They're giving me just enough money to continue playing. Joker. You know what? I'll go Joker immediately. Yep. Yep. Rotten Baby is worthwhile. Rotten Baby makes flies on occasion. And flies are real good in this video game. They're real powerful. Come on, I want them to drop hearts. I want to play the Blood Bank as much as possible. Because I don't want to have to take blood... I don't want to have to take red hearts from Gimpy. Gimpy, from Dark Bomb. But I will. See? I just stole it straight out of his face. Fucking hell, nothing. Jesus. It's like we're in a draw. Oh, fuck. I hate rooms like this, where there's actually just a continual enemy just there. It's just a turret that you can't deal with. It's just there to remind you, fuck you. Signed sincerely, this video game. Okay, you should be dead real quick. Same with you, Chubster. Anyway, Rotten Baby is really good, especially for the fact that we currently have a lot of damage. We do a lot of damage. And the flies that he spawns, and for that matter, the spiders that we're spawning, do damage relative to that. I want that. Not what I was trying to do. Okay, a bomb for three bombs. Let's try and find the secret room. Shouldn't be too difficult. I can play the blood... Bah, fuck! I can play the blood... Bah, fuck! What I was gonna say is I can play the Blood Bank twice, but if possible, I would like to pick up the, I'd like to pick up the PhD before I do that, because the PhD actually increases the amount of money that the Blood Bank drops for you when you pay it. When you play it, sorry. So it's a rich get richer situation. As soon as I have the money for it, I'll have the money to do more things with it. Damn it. Is it... Oh, it can't be down there, so it cannot be that room. It still can be this one, though. There we go. Not quite enough money. Close, but not quite enough. I might gamble away part of a spirit heart here. Oh, Gimpy gave us actually some money. Nice. Oh, Gimpy! Gimpy fucking paying out like a boss. Excellent. Also, the PhD is gonna almost full heal us. It heals us 3 hearts. So, I will go back and play the Blood Bank once more. Because, hey, why not? Now, I can purchase a Spirit Heart for 5 cents there. With the PhD, playing the Blood Bank twice should get me more than 5 cents. And also, Gimpy has a possibility of dropping Spirit Hearts for me while I'm doing that. So I might as well play a Spirit Heart's worth. Yeah, exactly. Because Gimpy, if he pays out, not only evens us out, perfect, that's exactly what I was hoping for, not only evens us out, but means that I get the money to purchase another Spirit Heart. We're in a real good position. Very good. Very good. 2 clubs. Yeah, I'll double that. Excellent. And now we can go and kill Mom. Because I'm really hoping to get that that boss rush mode. Ooh. Can't wait to get into boss rush, only 8 minutes too late. Oh, go for it. Go for it. Give me the blood. Yay! I love you, Dark Bum. You're my favorite item. It's true, he is my favorite item. Okay, so we've got the Chariot and the Magician at the moment, so I'll trade the Magician again. Excellent. Chariot and the Magician is probably some of the best I could ask for. And fight over. So the negative has been picked up. Please. Oh my god. I knew there were no guppy items in there. I'm a dummy. But. Okay. I really wish I knew what 5 did before I did it. Because I might have had more things to capitalize on. I don't know. With the amount of bombs we have, and the fact that we can hold 2 cards at the same time. Yes! I will... Fuck it, man. I'll use a tower, I don't give a shit. Okay. The Fool... Hey, look at this. Man, I might as well just fight it. Just get another drop at the end. At a certain point, you realize you're powerful enough that you might as well just not avoid fights. Might as well just dive headfirst into them. Yep, there we go. Got a Spirit Heart as the drop at the end. And that. So we're never going to run low on Spirit Hearts, basically, is kind of what they're saying here. Ooh, that's an Eternal Heart. Joker, excellent. What do we got? Fuck you too, game. All right, yes, I'll take a Spirit Heart. So now I'm flying, and I got, spectral tears, yeah, but, yeah, it doesn't really matter, because I wanted to be guppy, so, you know, I'm just gonna spit in the face of all of the amazing things that have just happened to me, because I didn't get guppy, and that's what I wanted. Judgment, oh yes, here we go, Judgment. I took 2 Spirit Hearts worth of damage to rescue you from your grave. Excellent. Box, what do you got in for me? Pinky Eye is pretty much... Yes, Hierophant is 2 Soul Hearts. Hermit is a random teleport now, since I don't have any shops left. Or since there aren't any shops left in the game, since we're on the womb. Come on, pop up, buddy. Buddy, pop up, you bastard. There you go. Yeah, gotcha. Where were the mum's hands? I thought there were mum's hands in there. I heard the laugh of the mum, which means there's mum's hands. What the fuck? They all dropped. Okay, look at I'm gonna try and make sure that Dark Bomb doesn't meet me before he picks up everything in this room. Look at this. Just pooping out soul hearts all day. I love it. Wait a second. I have the compass. Why am I dicking around on any room that isn't the final room? Yeah, I have the compass. I might as well just go straight there. Thank you to Spectral Shots for allowing me to very easily and quickly clear that room. Now, I do expect to be able to go and fight Sheol, and I don't think I've done that with Eden yet, so I may as well. I'm gonna try and keep Dark Bomb away from- nah, he already drops the heart. Oh, well. Oh, excellent. Another judgment. At this point, I'm just doing it for funsies. It really doesn't matter. So, that's, to me, that, that HP up represents three spirit hearts that I can have at any time. Since I have Guppy's Paw. I did use a Joker at the start of this floor, didn't I? And then I got the Spirit of the Night and I was real disappointed. So that means that there is officially no longer any way for me to get a deal with the devil and pick up a guppy item from that. I still can get guppy items, don't get me wrong. I still can. It's just less likely. It would have to be from red chests, basically, at this point. Oh, look, nothing. Look, it's fucking nothing. I will actually, because I am a giant quivering quim, go back and pick up the soul hearts that I've left in other rooms. I'll have left like 5 soul hearts in this room, so I might as well just, yeah. Bang. Bang, right on them. And since I've already basically full cleared the womb, I may as well just actually full clear the womb. He just dropped another spirit heart in that room. That's what I mean about Dark Bomb. At certain points with Dark Bomb, you cannot die. He just... he's gonna make you win the run whether you want to or not. I don't actually foresee anything good happening to me as a result of continuing to gamble in that room. So I may as well just move. Yep. I mean, what? The best thing that I think could happen to me is I fight, what? Fucking Ultra Pride, and I pick up the left hand, and I get a lot of drops of, what are they called here? A lot of drops of red chests, and then I pick up a guppy item, and then, well, yeah. The story writes itself. It lives! Okay, and it lives. It dies. Okay, now, important choice to make. Do I go upwards or do I go downwards? I have the negative, so I could fight Satan and then fight the lamb. Which I don't think I've actually ever done on camera before. Well, I have done it on camera, but then I had to lose the... well, I did lose the episodes. Thanks to OBS, basically having it out for me. Which is why I now record in very small chunks, so that if I do lose footage, I only lose about an hour. Thanks, OBS. I think it might have been due to the fact that I was playing Clicker Hero in the background, and Clicker Heroes is actually surprisingly CPU intensive. It might have been that. Alternatively, I'll blame anyone that isn't me, so. Gimpy is doing a lot of work, dropping soul hearts every time I get hit. Well, basically every time I get hit. No, I didn't want to go in here. Man. I was planning on going into that curse room and seeing if I could, you know, pick up the lost part of my guppy items. Because I got 2 guppy items real early. That's a pentagram, that's a lot more damage. I'm not gonna complain. Because I do that too much. Having the compass when I go down to the next floor, wink, wink, nudge, nudge, for anyone that's aware of the next floor.
It's a guppy item!
Alright, I'm gonna... You know what? I actually probably want the other one. I probably want the paw, to be completely honest. Just for the safety of continued existence. Three, two, drop the bomb. Three, two. Fuck, man, I was off by like half a second. Stupid. And that kills that version of Satan. And now the feet come down, and it's time to kill. There we go, done. Well played. Oh man, it looks like there's a chest. We're just gonna have to go into the chest and... Oh, what's that? It didn't end the game. We're going down to another floor. You don't say. Also in the dark room, there's these four... These. Holy shit, all of them were good. That's real cool. There's those four... I don't know what you'd call them. What? What, you'd call them red chests? There's four of them at the very start, so our chances of becoming Guppy were relatively high. Anyhow, this is a secret level that can be accessed after fighting Satan so long as you hold the Polaroid when you go into the chest. It is like the anti-version of the chest for anyone that is familiar with the first game. It is like the Nega version of that. N-E-G-A. Specifically. Our flies are just doing an absurd amount of damage. Like, at this point, the game is over. The game just doesn't know it yet. I want to save up some flies so that when I go into the lamb fight, I just immediately win. There we go. Okay. I'm gonna go in, and then I'm gonna immediately pop that. So now I have the devil card active as well. Okay. So now, if I can just live through this fight. Excellent, well done. and this, for the moment. Oh, that's the missing poster that I got last episode. That, okay, so I unlocked it when I did this the first time. On a camera run that was lost. Ah, excellent. There's Mum being menacing in the background. We'll skip through the development stuff. We've unlocked the mystery sack. My name has been Rhapsody. The name of the game has been The Binding of Isaac Rebirth. We played Eden, and we beat the shit out of the lamb. We showed him our wrath. Hopefully you've been enjoying yourself. If you have, please click like. There's a play button. There's a description down in the... Please click like, it does help me get my content out to new people. There's a playlist down in the description if you'd like to play more, watch more Binding of Isaac content by me. If I could trip over my words anymore, I fucking promise you I would. Hopefully you've been enjoying yourself and we'll see you next time.